Thanks to the release of Deno 2, building performant full-stack apps is easier than ever. Let me show you. Let's set up Drizzle ORM with Deno and Postgres to build a small application that creates, reads updates, and deletes dinosaur data. First, we'll install the required dependencies using Deno's NPM compatibility. We'll be using Drizzle with Postgres, but you can also use other SQL tools. This command installs Drizzle and its associated tools. Drizzle kit for schema migrations, PG for Postgres connectivity, and all the needed TS types. These packages will allow us to interact with the database in a type-safe way while maintaining compatibility with Deno's runtime environment. This command will also create a Deno.json file in the root of our project. Next, let's create a Drizzle configuration where we'll set up where to place the migration files, where to find the schema definition, and the database connection details. Due to this configuration, we'll also need a .environment file containing the database URL connection string. Okay, now let's move to something more interesting and define our schemas. There are two ways that you can define your table schema with Drizzle. If you already have Postgres tables defined, you can infer them with pull. Otherwise, you can define them in code, then use Drizzle to create a new table. Let's quickly explore both options. First, if you already have Postgres tables before adding Drizzle, then you can introspect your database schema to automatically generate TypeScript types and table definitions with the pull command. This is particularly useful when working with an existing database or when you want to ensure your code stays in sync with your database structure. The command will create a number of files within a Drizzle directory that define the schema, track changes, and provide the necessary information for database migrations. If you are starting a completely new project and you don't already have an existing table defined in Postgres, you can define the tables and types in code and have Drizzle create them. Let's add a new directory called database, and in it, a schema.ts file, which will populate with the appropriate tables and column types. Note that defining types and the primary key is really straightforward. We are also defining a foreign key to establish a relationship between the task table and the dinosaurs table. This ensures referential integrity, meaning that you can't create a task with a dinosaur ID that doesn't exist in the dinosaurs table. On top of that, if a dinosaur is deleted, you need to handle its associated tasks. Once we have defined the schema, we can create the tables and their specified relationship by creating a migration. Now, for the really fun part, once we have the ORM set up, we can use it to simplify managing data in our Postgres database. First, Drizzle suggests taking the schema and relations.ts files and copying them to the database directory to use within an application. Next, we'll use a database TypeScript file to export a few helper functions that'll make it easier for us to interact with the database. We will first instantiate the Drizzle client with Postgres driver and schema. Then, we can easily define our create, read, update, and delete methods. Again, pretty straightforward stuff using the provided seamless Drizzle APIs. Next, we can import some of these helper functions to a script where we perform some simple CRUD operations on our database. Of course, this is a naive implementation, and in real-world apps, you'd have exposed REST endpoints receiving data from your users, validation layers, and other business-related logic. Finally, we'll run the script file using the Deno run command, and everything should work smoothly. With this solid foundation, there are multiple avenues we can pursue next, so be sure to subscribe for more Deno-related tutorials. Until next time, thank you for watching!